Are you considering studying law as part of an undergraduate dual degree at UNSW in 2017?
Then you need to know about the new law admission test.
UNSW Law is ranked as the 15th top law school worldwide, and demand to study law is very high.
That's why we're introducing the Law Admission Test, or LAT, to give you the opportunity to further demonstrate your suitability for our law program.
We'll look at both your LAT results and your ATAR or academic results. Your ATAR is still important because law is a challenging degree.
But to become a UNSW law student, you'll need to show us that you're a critical thinker,
a problem solver, and a clear communicator.
That's what we'll be looking for when you sit the LAT. But don't worry, you won't need any knowledge specific to law.
You'll have 2 hours to answer 2 questions that require written responses.
So, if you want to study an undergraduate law dual degree and you are in year 11 or 12,
or you have already completed high school and are working or are on a gap year,
or you are at university and want to transfer into law, then you should sit the LAT.
Here's what you need to do.
Register for the LAT from May, sit the LAT in September,
and don't forget to submit your UAC application.
For more information, subscribe to our LAT email updates,
check out the FAQs,
or come along to an information event.
I'd like to begin tonight's proceedings by acknowledging the traditional custodians of the land on which we're gathered and to pay my respects to their elders, past and present. And I'd also like to especially welcome any Aboriginal or Torres Strait Islander people here tonight. And to everyone else, welcome to UNSW and to UNSW Law's Information Evening. We've had to move to this large theatre in response to the overwhelming uptake of our invitation to come to the information night. So I'd like to thank you all for your interest and for making the trip out here this evening. Tonight, we're going to be covering the following topics: why study law, why UNSW law, what dual degrees do we have on offer for next year, how you can seek admission for 2017, including the new law admissions test, transfer entry for those who don't come in straight from school, and there'll be time for questions at the end of that. So why study law, you might ask? I'd say because law opens up a whole range of opportunities. Working as a lawyer means different things to different people. Many people imagine working as a lawyer involving clever courtroom tactics, closing multi-million dollar property deals, defending in high-profile murder trials, advising on corporate takeovers, or prosecuting those accused of organised crime. In fact, working as a lawyer can involve anything from drafting a will to drafting an international treaty, from conveying a studio apartment to conveying an office tower, from advising on the purchase of the local corner store to working on a takeover of Google. It can involve acting for an individual who's lost his or her job, or acting for the International Labour Organisation. It can involve advising on specific sections of the Dividing Fences Act or developing policy regarding amendments to the Constitution. The examples are infinite. Basically, lawyers can be and are involved in every facet of life. Now, thinking like a lawyer can again mean an extremely broad array of things. Generally, this is taken to mean thinking analytically, thinking critically, thinking precisely, thinking carefully, being able to solve problems, being able to see things from different perspectives, being able to argue persuasively, and being able to present the best possible case. UNSW law sees thinking like a lawyer to involve all those things, but also to involve an understanding of society. So strict legal rules and rationales have their place, but must be learned and used within the much broader context of the real world. Not just what is the law, but how does the law work? Does it work? How should it work? What is its effect? Does it make society better? Does it impact differently on different groups of people? Could it be improved? These are the broader considerations and the kind of questions which we believe are part and parcel of thinking like a lawyer. So if you want to study law, why UNSW Law? UNSW Law is consistently ranked amongst the top 15 law schools in the world. Our research is consistently ranked with the highest possible ranking under the government's ERA, or Excellence in Research Assessment. We also offer more clinics and internships than any other Australian law school, which is part of our commitment to ensuring that thinking like a lawyer includes understanding and engaging with society. So what's distinctive about UNSW Law? When UNSW Law was established 45 years ago, it saw itself as a progressive, social justice-oriented law school. That is as true today as it was then. But that doesn't mean we don't change, only that the school's underlying values remain constant and connecting law with justice remains a priority. But we're also forward-looking. Our programs, our courses, and our research looks to the future in the sense of ensuring that our graduates are prepared for a new and constantly changing world, and our research both anticipates and shapes what happens next. In addition, we see students as an integral part of the law school, not separate from it, and they're encouraged to get involved with the research projects of academics and of centres. They have lots of opportunities for involvement in the law school governance and in the broader university community. We offer a peer mentoring program for pastoral and social support and a peer tutor program for academic support. In addition, we've recently introduced a law-specific careers service to help students to realise their aspirations after graduation. UNSW Law recently undertook an extensive curriculum review, which resulted in the introduction of a new law curriculum in 2013. We took account of the many changes occurring in the legal arena and in society more generally. We examined best practice examples from both Australia and overseas, and consulted extensively with students, staff, and the broader legal profession. One outcome of this was the introduction of a mandatory course on law in the global context. Another was the creation of the Law Careers Office. Our new curriculum is organised to ensure that students have a good grasp of what are traditionally considered to be the fundamental areas of legal knowledge, along with the necessary technical skills to deal with those areas. But in addition, our curriculum also ensures that students are exposed to new and emerging areas and are able to view all of these from multiple perspectives. We've ensured that a broad variety of legal skills are developed throughout the curriculum, and they're all underpinned by UNSW Law's values. Our classes are interactive. We expect students to be prepared for class and to participate in this class. Through doing this, we help students to develop better thinking and communication skills and to engage more deeply with the subject matter and with their peers and teachers. And I should mention, we never have classes like this in law. We don't have a lecture theatre. We don't have any classes in lecture theatres. And in fact, the reason we've had to move up here tonight is because we don't have this kind of space in the law school. As I've mentioned, UNSW law students are encouraged to actively engage beyond the classroom. We have a full mooting or mock trial program within the law school, from beginners through intermediate and advanced levels. At the highest levels, students may compete internationally in mooting and in other competitions, such as mediation and commercial arbitration competitions. We have exchange agreements with over 70 international partners spread across North and South America, Europe and Asia. We run short courses overseas. This year, we're offering these courses in New York and Berkeley in the United States, in Santiago in Chile, Zurich in Switzerland, and Shanghai in China. We also offer internships within our centres at UNSW and more broadly in Australia and overseas. Internships cover a very diverse range of topics and organisations, such as the Australian Football Federation, Samoan Law Reform Commission, National Australia Bank, the Federal Court, and the Judicial Monitoring Program in Timor-Leste, amongst many others. In clinical practice, we have many courses run through our own Kingsford Legal Centre, which is the community legal centre attached to UNSW Law. We run clinical courses also with other partners, such as the Police Powers Clinic, the Human Rights Clinic, and the Land and Environment Court Clinic. Just to give you an idea of the breadth of the centres at UNSW Law, all of these centres are housed within UNSW and take students and welcome student engagement. So, moving from there to admission. Firstly, this is just to give you an idea of what's available at UNSW Law next year. I think you probably know that all our undergraduate students do dual degrees. We don't offer any undergraduate straight law degree, and students can combine law with about 25 different areas. So there should be something there for everyone, no matter how esoteric or bizarre your interests are. You should be able to find something at UNSW. Now, moving on to the law admission test. I'm sure you're all aware that UNSW has introduced a new law admission test known as the LAT or the LAT. We will no longer grant bonus points to elite athletes and performers as we have done in the past. We will, however, still allow points for long-term educational disadvantage under the Access Scheme. And we'll award triple A points for the Ducks of each school in New South Wales. So, why are we changing? We already have and have had fantastic students. However, at every open day and information session, we've been asked by people who were not in the elite athletes and performers class if there was some other way that they could show their suitability for law studies. And it did appear to make more sense to allow applicants to improve their chance of a place in law school by demonstrating skills and abilities that were directly relevant to law studies. Hence, the introduction of the new law admission test, or LAT. LAT will assess things like critical thinking, logical reasoning, problem-solving approaches, clarity of thought, and the ability to generate and express ideas. LAT will not require any knowledge specific to law, and it will be conducted by the Australian Council for Educational Research on behalf of UNSW Law. You probably, whether you're familiar with ASA or not, you've probably, all the students in the audience, have probably done tests that have been administered and designed by ASA. ASA also run things like selective school test and the medical tests and tests for other professional faculties. Who will need to sit the LAT? All Australian citizens applying for law at UNSW, all permanent residents of Australia, and New Zealand citizens. Applicants currently in Year 12 or equivalent, or currently on a gap year, will need to sit the LAT to be considered for entry to UNSW Law in 2017. Students wishing to transfer to UNSW Law from another university will also need to sit the LAT to be considered for entry next year. Students in Year 11 may also sit the LAT. So here is what you need to do if you'd like to study at UNSW Law. If you're in any of the categories that has been mentioned, you need to register from 2nd of May and sit the LAT on the 26th of September. For the details, I know the slide's small, but the LAT will comprise two questions. It will run for 2 hours. It will be held on 26th September only. And there'll be test centres in Sydney, Canberra, Armidale and Dubbo. LAT results will be valid for 2 years. And Year 11 students who wish to sit the test prior to their HSC year may do so. Students will be able to sit the test more than once, and if students do sit the test more than once, their best result will be considered for entry. We anticipate that students will still need an ATAR of around 95 or above for entry to UNSW Law and a high score in the LAT. We're currently trialling a version of the LAT to ensure that the test papers are suitable for their purpose and that assessment rubrics are valid. ASA, as I said, has considerable experience in this area, including through running the entry tests for other schools. There will be a sample test paper available prior to the LAT and in plenty of time before the exam is held. However, other than familiarising yourself with the format of the LAT through that test paper, that sample test paper, we don't expect you to be doing any particular preparation for the LAT or to have any particular or law-specific knowledge for that test. Finally, for transfer entry, particularly for people who come into UNSW, into another faculty, and then want to transfer over. Presently, if a UNSW student wishes to transfer into law, they do so through internal program transfer and don't need to sit the LAT. However, if a student wishes to come from another university to UNSW Law, they'll need to sit the LAT and apply via UAC. Their school results, their university results, and their LAT results will all be taken into account for those students transferring from another university. The next steps for you will be to check the website, the address of which you'll have, and to email if you have specific questions that aren't answered tonight, or in the frequently asked questions, or on the website, or anywhere else.